We've heard a lot about staff shortages lately, especially with low unemployment.
One sector is so short of workers, it's come up with a plan to inspire people into a different lifestyle altogether.
So, you reckon you've got what it takes to be a dairy farmer? Hit it!
This is Shannon. She used to be a city slicker, but a lifestyle transformation saw her switch to dairy farming, and she loves it. Shannon's the face of a new campaign to inspire others to follow her lead. Because the dairy industry is desperate for workers. 4,000 to be exact. And with the season starting on June 1st, there's no time like the present.
And for more on this, we're joined by TVNZ Chief Executive Tim Mackle. Thanks for your time, Tim. How are you hoping this new campaign will attract people?
Yeah, kia ora, Jeremy and Hillary. Look, it's about connecting Kiwis with dairying, you know, telling the story of the opportunities that's available. So we're 4,000 people down. We've got about 11,000 farms. About one third of farmers are understaffed. So we're trying to attract people and bring them on board.
And what kind of pressure is the industry under right now?
Well, look, it's really hard for farmers. I mean, I have farmers contacting me, you know, talking about the fact that at the kitchen table at night, they talk about how they're going to manage their way through when they're short-staffed. It's hard on other staff, too. They're going to pick up extra load as well. And there's other things we're thinking about, too. You know, like how do we keep making environmental improvements, looking after the animals? And at the same time, I mean, you know, there's a lot at stake here, too. I think the forecast for the end of June is that dairy will bring in almost $21 billion of export receipts. It's over 35%. So there's actually quite a lot at stake too for the whole country, not just for farmers on this.
And what difference would another 4,000 workers make to the industry?
Oh, look, it would be a huge relief. I think it would just take the pressure off. There's so many great opportunities as well for people to come on to dairy. So I think first and foremost for them, you know, it's a lifestyle, let's face it. You know, if you've got little kids, you can see them at breakfast, at lunchtime, afternoon tea, dinner, that might be too much for you. But look, it's a great thing. No commute. Most of them live on farm. And so in today's, you know, a climate with high inflation and so on, that's attractive, you know, and great pay rates and great pathways with lots of training. So huge opportunity for Kiwis joining us, and at the same time it would really help our sector as well.
I like sleeping in wearing suits and hate getting my hands dirty. Would dairy farming suit me, Tim?
Well, actually, these days, unlike when I was a kid, Jeremy, they have gloves for milking, so I think your hands would be okay. And I was just thinking, by the back door, I found a long pair of boots that will keep your suit pants clean. Oh. And Hillary, some trendy red bands. But the sleep-ins, you're just going to have to get used to it, mate, I think.
I love it. Okay, here's your last plug, Tim. Why should people consider a farming lifestyle?
Well, it is lifestyle, you know. No commute for many because you live on the farm. That's great with today's costs, you know, inflation and so on. Great pay rates. You can walk off the street and get $55,000 with no skills. And then you add accommodation and you add meat and milk into it, and it becomes pretty attractive. And the pathway from there is pretty great. So it's a great lifestyle. I think the last point would be purpose. You're part of a sector that is providing, you know, low-carbon dairy, wonderful, wholesome nutrition to the world. And that's a great thing to be part of.
Thanks, Tim. I'll see you tomorrow.
Good to see you in the morning. About 5 o'clock, Hillary?
Yeah, no worries. No worries. See you then.
Okay, cool. Thanks, guys.
Bye.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
It's all right. I'm not turning up in the morning. I'm too soft. Truly, I don't want to get my hands. I was just trying to make Tim feel better. I'll be here.
Promise is a promise. Look, Tim's already sent me your gumboots.
Oh, no.
Look, here they are.
They're
here.
Far too clean.
No.
Those actually are my gumboots. Never been worn, you see. They're nice. I polish them. I can't get those dirty.
I'd love to help Tim out, but I've got my gumboots. He didn't send them to me.